Hello everyone, let's start our chapter 6, Geography, Human Resource. Yes, people are the nation's greatest resource. Nature's bounty becomes significant only when people find it useful. People who work on natural resource of a country to produce wealth and raise the standard of living. People provide the inexhaustible resource of cheap manpower for producing agriculture and manufacturing goods. The way in which land, sea, minerals, forest, water supplies are used varies greatly in the world. This is mainly due to the wide variation in human number, human type, and the stage of development of different human groups, human skill, human talent. A country which is underpopulated cannot exploit its natural resource to the maximum. But if the country is overpopulated, ज्यादा है वहां की population, it's provide a burden on her resources. Because the consumption of resources is high. So the population of country is a greater resource only when or if it is within limit in respect of the known natural resource. We should think about population control. Our country means the government of India has a Ministry of Human Resource Development, which was created in 1985. Why it was created? The main aim to improve the people's skill, talent, and this association work on it. This just show how the important people are as resource for a country. If the people of that country are educated, healthy, well-mannered, or strong, we can say that is strong country. But as you know, har cheez limit mein achhi lagti hai. So we should think about to control population. And the government also take initiative step for this. Government taking initiative step to convert their educated people, converted healthy people, healthy citizens. Human resource like the other resource are not equally distributed over the world. Yes. If we talk about the mountain area, plain area, so the plain area is a more populated as we compare with the mountainous and desertic area. There's a reason, obvious reason, like the form of that land, terrain, topography, the climate, and other, which is the necessity of life, like education opportunity over there, health of facility, entertainment facility. Understood? So now, have a look this conversation. There is a the teach between the teacher and the students. So the first, my village has 1,000 people. There are 500 children in school. How many people do you think there are in the whole world? There are, he said, 30 children in my class. What do you write that in numbers? 6.6 billion people in population. He given the answer of that question, the question asked by the teacher, how many population in the world? So he said 6.6 billion people. So here, yes, as the resources are not evenly distributed on the earth, same way the human resource also not evenly distributed on the earth. You can see this figure number 6.1, world population by continent. So the yellow people, those live in Asia, and this live in Europe, purple live in Africa, blue live in Central and South America, and magenta live in America, and green live in Oceania, like Australia, New Zealand, Pacific Island. So you can see the some area crowded, and those are live in Asia, and the some are sparsely populated, like North America and New Zealand and Australia. So we can see that the human resource also not evenly distributed on the earth. The way in which the people spread across the earth of the surface known as the pattern of population distribution. So you can, through this data, you can give that, yes ma'am, in Asia continent, the Asia continent is populated if we compare with the Oceania or the North America. The 90% of the world population live in which part of the continent? Asia, and the rest the other. About 30% of the land surface, the distribution of population in the world is extremely uneven. Some area very crowded, as you can see in Asia, and the are, and some are sparsely populated, like North America and Australia and New Zealand. The crowded area are South and Southeast Asia, Europe and Northeastern Northern America. A very few people live in high latitude area, tropical desert, high mountains and high equatorial forests. Many more people live in the north of the equator. When we move toward the equator, north, then the south of equator. Because the most of the part of the land area is in which? In northern hemisphere. So that is why the most of the part of the people live in this area, north hemisphere. Almost 3/4 of the world people live in the two continents, see, Asia and Africa. Am I right? 60% of world population stay in the 10 countries. All of them have more than 100 million people. So, among all continents, the Asia and the Africa, the two continents where the most of the people live. Now, look at this 6.2, the world most populous country. So, here you can see through this pie chart, the China, the country which have China is the most densely populated country. Then next one is India, then USA, Indonesia, Brazil, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Nigeria, Russia, and Japan. Now, what do you understand by the mean of density of population? Means the number of people living in specified area of the earth. If we talk about the per square kilometer in India, the per square kilometer in India, that is the 400 people living in India. As we compare with the other Australian, other only 40 to 50 people are living. The average density of the whole world is 51% per square kilometer. As we compare the India having the population density, average density is 400 people living in per square kilometer. So now the two friends talking with each other, let's have a look. When all 30 students are present in our classroom, seems very crowded because the area is small. But when the same class is seated in the school assembly hall, there's the assembly hall, kya hai? is bigger than the classroom, so it seems so open and empty. Has I given the answer? Yes, because the size or the area of the hall is much larger than the classroom. So the however, when the all the students of the school come into the hall, so the hall too start looking crowded, because here the hall is big, but the number of the people is also increased. So the student of all the student of school, whole school, all student of the school. Now come to the next, the factor affecting the distribution of population. So there are the different factors which affect the distribution of population. So there are the geographical factor and social, economic and cultural factor. First let's talk about geographical factor. So first geographical factor is topography of the area. If the topography of area means the area is a plain, so that is a high densely populated, if we compare with the mountain and desertic area. That is like if we talk about our country, so the Ganga plain is a most densely populated area if we compare with the mountain and desertic area. Fine. Now the next one is climate. Yes, people usually avoid extreme climatic conditions. So people mostly avoid that area where that area found extreme climate, which area is not good for habitation, like the extreme climate that are like hot and short, kuch bhi ho sakta hai. So the Sahara Desert polar region in Russia, Canada and Antarctica, the people avoid to settle in these areas. So the climate also is a very important, a big factor for distribution of population, which affect the distribution of population. The next factor is soil. If the fertile soil provide in that area, so that area is a most densely populated, because it provides the profession occupation activity. Fertile area good for the agriculture activity, and the people avoid that area which is less fertile. If the water facility is good, or the fresh water is available, easily available there, the people start living and settle down that area. It also affects the distribution of population. Now the next one is a mineral. How the mineral affect the distribution of population? Yes, if the area is a rich mineral ore, found rich mineral ore in that area, the people find out the occupation, employment there, which attract the people to settle this area. For example, the people living near the Chhattisgarh and Jharkhand area, and the people living near the south diamond mines of South Africa. Okay. Now next one is the social, cultural and economic factor. Yes. So first the social, the area for better housing, education and health facility are more densely populated. Everyone wants to settle that area where they easily get health facility, education facility for their children and for the higher education, and good housing facility. The security purpose, that area should be good. So the people want to settle that area. So that is a social factor. Religious factor, that if that area is a religious point of view is very good place with the religion, cultural significant attract the people. That is why the people wanted to settle in Mathura area, Haridwar, Varanasi, Vatican City. Now the next one is the economic factor. The industrial area provide the employment opportunity, so that is why the large number of people attract these area. They wanted to settle down that area, like Osaka in Japan, Ahmedabad in India, Mumbai in India. So these are the densely populated area, because the people easily get employment opportunity over there. Why the people settle down near Gurgaon? The people know the many MNC set up their plant over there. That is why the people start settle down Gurgaon area, Noida area. Easy to reach over there to their offices. Now the next one, very important, is life expectancy. What does it mean? Yes, it means the number of years that people expect to live in that country. If we talk about our country, so our country, the life expectancy age is 70 to 75. Indians aadmi itna jeeta hai, 75 to 80. So that is the number of years the people expect to, average person expect to live. That is the mean of life expectancy. I hope it is understood by all.